Hello students, in the last class we discussed about condensation polymerization and its various examples. The last example was melamic polymer. Students, there in the notes we had not written the word polymer, write it down. So melamic polymer was formed by the condensation polymerization of melamine and formaldehyde. Now in continuation to that, and the last topic, we are going to discuss biodegradable polymers. So let's understand the meaning of biodegradable polymers. We know that polymers nowadays, they are very important in our day-to-day life, okay? But most of them, they are not decomposed by the microorganisms, especially bacteria, by their enzyme-catalyzed reactions like hydrolysis, decomposition, oxidation reaction. So they remain accumulated there. Now, when they remain accumulated, they create a lot of problem. They create a polymeric waste and it is harmful for our environment. So to solve that problem, nowadays biodegradable polymers are synthesized, they are being designed and synthesized. Now let's understand the meaning of the term. Biodegradable polymers, that means polymers that can be broken down into small fragments or small segments. What do we mean by this term, broken down into small segments? That means they can be decomposed by microorganisms, and microorganism produces certain enzymes which catalyzes the reactions that I have already told you, like oxidation, decomposition, or it can be hydrolysis, the reactions which decomposes them. Now, because they can be decomposed, they do not cause pollution. So environmental degradation problem has been solved. Environmental quality, it doesn't get degraded. Now, they contain functional groups similar to those present in biopolymers. Exactly the functional groups which are present in the biopolymers, they are having the same. What are biopolymers? Like cellulose, protein, polynucleotide chain, that is DNA, RNA, like that. Now, in this, we are going to discuss two biodegradable polymers. The first one, it is PHPP, that is aliphatic polyester. Okay, now, what is PHBB? Poly beta hydroxybutylate co beta hydroxyvalerate. Actually, it is a copolymer of two monomers. First one, it is 3-hydroxybutanoic acid, and second one is 3-hydroxypentenoic acid. Let's write the structure. Now this is a carboxylic acid group. The carbon attached to this, it is alpha, and the next carbon it is beta. And to this beta carbon, OH group is attached, so it is beta hydroxy, four carbon, so it is butyric acid. So beta hydroxy butyric. This is either, we can write the IUPAC name or the common name, 3-hydroxy. I have written the IUPAC name. The second monomer, it is 3-hydroxypentenoic acid. This is COH, again the functional group carboxylic acid. This is alpha carbon and this is beta carbon. To the beta carbon, OH group is attached, hydroxy group is attached. So this is beta hydroxy. When we are writing the IUPAC name, we will write down the number. So it is 1, 2 and 3. 3-hydroxy. How many carbons are there? 5. So it is pentanoic acid. Now, when they undergoes polymerization, what happens? From this OH, H, and from this COH, the OH part, they reacts. This OH reacts with the H of the next monomer, and this OH reacts with the H of the next. So this H will be reacting with the OH of the previous monomer. So let's write the structure, how the PHBB can be written. See students, we have to start with
this O. Okay, so here O, O, it is attached to CH, and this CH3 we are going to write on the lower side. CH3 then CH2 then C double bond O. After this O, we are going to attach with this O, not this one. Okay, so after this O, we will take it from here. O. Okay, now this O is attached to CH. Now to this CH, one ethyl group is present. I am going to write it on the lower side. Okay, now to this CH, CH2 and then CO. Okay, so this is the structure of PHBB. Many a times in the board exam, this has been asked. Example of biodegradable polymer, its meaning and the monomers and the structure of the PHBB. So students, just practice of writing of the structure. Now the second more polymer, that is biodegradable polymer, we are going to discuss. It is nylon 2, nylon 6. Nylon 2, nylon 6. Actually, it is a copolymer of two monomers, that is glycine and aminocaproic acid. And this is a polyamide. Okay. So, first I am taking the structure of glycine. NH2, CH2, COOH. This is glycine. Okay. And another monomer, it is aminocaproic acid. Let's write the structure. NH2, CH2, COOH. Okay. Now, nylon 2, nylon 6, it is polyamide. So, from here, NH2 part H and from COH, OH will come out, okay, in the form of water. Similarly, this OH will combine with the H of the next glycine molecule, and this H will combine with the another aminocaproic acid molecule. H will combine with its OH. So, let's write the structure. We will start with this NH. NH. Okay. Then CH2, then C double bond O, here I have written, then NH, then CH2 5, and then we are having C double bond O. So this is our nylon 2, nylon. So in this way, students, we have completed our chapter polymers, and keep on studying.